6-8's weather on the 8s with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
6:38, didn't quite get a freeze last night. Our average first freeze comes right around the 28th of October, so we're not that far off of that. The earliest we've ever had a freezing temperature was the 24th of September. That was back in 1963. The latest we've gone into the season is the 2nd of December. That was back in 85. That was a pretty mild year that year. In the meantime, for us, fairly cloudy today. Maybe near 50, but most of the day in the 40s, and add in a wind at 15, 20 miles an hour, it's going to feel pretty chilly out there with that brisk wind. Then partly cloudy skies, may get close to freezing overnight tonight, but most of us mid-30s, I think. And then clouds and sunshine, brisk, chilly day tomorrow. Look for temperatures tomorrow, lower 50s to mid-50s. I think we'll notch it up a couple of degrees each of the next few days, but still below normal temperatures right through the weekend. Looking live over the Capitol, that flag is flapping along right now. Yeah, that's making it feel quite brisk out there. Officially, Harrisburg at 42, partly cloudy skies. More clouds north and west of Harrisburg, less south and east of Harrisburg. But you see that wind west at 9 miles an hour. Again, I think it's going to be up around 15, 20 miles an hour at times today. Carlisle's at 37, 39 up in State College right now. So's York. Down to 34 in Lancaster. It's one of the cool spots, 36 in Shamokin. Most of the area is clear, but again, you get north and west of Harrisburg, you're starting to pick up some cloud cover. In fact, yeah, getting even some light rain showers coming in off the mountains out, heading south from Shippensburg down to Chambersburg, down toward Greencastle, Waynesboro, maybe a few sprinkles. And wouldn't shock me, you go up into the mountains west toward Breezewood, you see a few snowflakes mixed in. They're getting some lake effect snows out toward Cleveland. First school delays of the season for in and around the Cleveland area this morning, getting some pretty good snows there. You also see a little precipitation down here in the Tennessee, Kentucky, and back in West Virginia. There's a little disturbance moving on by, and I think that'll stir some clouds for us. Not much precipitation, though, but the big story is brisk and chilly weather through the day today into tonight, too, and right through tomorrow. And again, we're getting that wind off the lake, so that does bring in some clouds and that lake effect snow shower activity to the north and west of us. Tomorrow, though, and into Saturday, high pressure builds in a little more. Still brisk and chilly, but I think Saturday won't be as cool ahead of this cool front. We'll get more of a southwesterly flow of air. Should be a little more of a decent day on Saturday. So we'll notch it up a few degrees each of the next couple of days. We're still on the chilly side. The weekend not looking too bad. Again, that front probably comes through here with just some clouds Saturday night. Sunday's looking okay. Temperatures do moderate next week. Like I've been saying, I think we could start to get a little wet second half of next week. But I don't see real cold weather for next week. Just, you know, back to back.
Seasonal.
Where we should be.
Yeah, right.
Good.
Yeah. All right. Joe, thank you.
Thanks, Joe.